Hey friends, thanks for joining me on this new episode of Political Peaks. I'm your host, Diego Romo. Today on the show, we speak with Park City Council candidate Max Doilney about the importance of voter turnout. We learn about the newest candidate for governor here in Utah, and we get some road news updates so you can head into next week ensuring that you're gonna avoid all the traffic. We've got a lot to discuss today, so let's get right into it. A reminder that the Park City Municipal General Election is just right around the corner on Tuesday, November the 5th. If you need an update on how the general election is run, where you can cast your ballot, and more, you can head over to parkcity.tv and check out last week's episode of Political Peaks. We also put up all of our interviews with city council candidates over on the municipal news page at parkcity.tv, so head over there if you need a refresher. But today, we're going to focus more on voter turnout. Frankly, it's something that the entire Park City community can really improve on. Although we are a very engaged community, this year's primary election only saw a 28% voter turnout. Of the roughly 5,800 registered voters here in Park City, only 1,693 ballots were cast. Here is City Council candidate Max Doilney now on the importance of voter turnout.
I think voter turnout is a huge, huge deal in Park City. I would like to see people get elected with over 1,000 votes per person. So that will require 3,000 to 5,000 people voting. We have 8,500 residents right now. It would be great if we can get up to 60% of the people out to vote. And that's a really marginal goal for a community that's this involved. So the more people that vote, the better. And I'm happy with the results. As long as we have a high voter turnout, we know that we've got the will of the people serving in office.
So, in order to have a municipal government that truly represents the diverse set of voices and opinions here in Park City, we all have to show up to vote. And there's still time. The last day to register both in person and online is just a couple days away on Tuesday, October 29th. And if you register before that deadline, the Summit County Clerk's office will mail out your ballot so that you can participate in this year's general elections. If you aren't able to register before the 29th, well, you still have no excuse to not vote, because luckily here in Utah, we have same-day voter registration laws in place. That means you can head to the Summit County Clerk's office on Election Day, Tuesday, November 5th, to both register to vote and cast your ballot. As Max said, let's get the voter turnout for this general election closer to 60%. And if you're unsure of your voter registration status, you can head over to vote.utah.gov. There you can learn more about the election, and you can register to vote if you haven't already done so. And if you have any questions about same-day voter registration through the Summit County Clerk's office, you can call them at 435-336-3204. Continuing on the election trend, yet another candidate has thrown their hat in the ring for Utah's 2020 gubernatorial race. Salt Lake County Council Chair Amy Winder Newton formally announced her candidacy on Wednesday on a campaign video released through YouTube. According to a recent interview with the Salt Lake Tribune, the focuses of Winder Newton's campaign are air quality, affordable housing, and building infrastructure for both water and transportation, which, according to Winder Newton, are all symptoms of Utah's recent economic success, which continues to bring more and more people into the state every year. With some experts saying that we're expected to add 1 million more people to the state's population in the next decade. Winder Newton was recently re-elected to the Salt Lake County Council in 2018, and she'll keep her position there if she loses next year's race. She joins Lieutenant Governor Spencer Cox and Provo businessman Jeff Birmingham as declared candidates for the election. You can find out more about her campaign for governor by heading to her website, amyforgovernor.com. Now time for some quick news regarding traffic as you head into next week. Beginning tonight and going through Wednesday night, the Utah Department of Transportation will begin working on the I-215 eastbound I-80 exit near the entrance of Parley's Canyon. Crews will be working on it from 9:30 p.m. to 4:30 a.m., and drivers will need to use the 13th East exit on I-80 heading westbound in order to access Parley's Canyon heading east. Also a reminder that the speed limit on the stretch of SR 224 before you head into Park City has been reduced to 45 miles per hour. The Utah Department of Transportation cited wildlife collisions on SR 224 as the cause for the speed reduction. And the Park City Police Department announced that they will be monitoring that stretch of road much more closely as we head into the next few weeks. So avoid a ticket and slow down the next time you're on your way to Park City. That's it for us today here on Political Peaks. Thanks so much for tuning in. And remember to register to vote before that October 29th deadline. Otherwise, you can head in for same-day voter registration on Tuesday, November the 5th at the Summit County Clerk's Office. As always, follow us on all of our social media at Park City TV and head over to parkcity.tv for more great community content. I hope you all enjoy the rest of your week. Happy Halloween, and I'll see you next Sunday.